So clearly the effort by a Stefan Molyneux fan and crazed lunatic to dox me to get me to shut up has worked so very well that I won't ever be talking about Stefan Molyneux anymore from now on. So anyways, about Stefan Molyneux, people have asked me whether or not I was interested in debating him. And the answer was always no. And I made a few points about it. One was that Stefan Molyneux doesn't take the form of criticism that I have with him on the air, which is the accusations of organizing a cult and the accusations of the DMCA takedown, which he hasn't really fully addressed. He's jabbed at it, but never really offered a response yet outside of the Joe Rogan interview. And, I mean, recently he started taking debates about the UPB, and I have to say that that's probably because of my video. But I also asked about it in the forums right after I found out about it, was banned, and then they tracked me down on Facebook and banned me there too. So clearly they're not interested in talking with me. But let's just say that they are, and I send them a message. And they were totally willing to get me on the air and talk about this stuff. I'm not going to do it. And the reason why I'm not going to do it is because Stefan Molyneux is very good at being passive-aggressive. And he likes to take passive-aggressive jabs at people. And the intention is pretty clear, in my opinion. The reason why he's doing this is because he's trying to provoke a reaction. So, take, for example, the Anna Kasparian. I'm not sure if I'm saying her name right. But Anna from The Young Turks. Not a fan. But she was very keen on it to the extent that she didn't respond to it in the way that he was hoping to get a response from it. If I'm going to link a video down below and watch it. Someone has actually taken out all the little passive-aggressive jabs that he made at her. And a lot of it's under the guise of jokes. Like, he's telling jokes. Like, he's being funny. But they are jabs. And Stefan Molyneux fans just eat it up. But what they don't see is that these are intentional jabs to get an emotional response from him. And if the person does respond emotionally, if someone gets upset or someone starts getting sad or whatever, then they can turn around and say, like, you know, oh, Stefan Molyneux was, you know, being polite, he was being funny, and they got offended and then, you know, had this big emotional response. They got angry, they cursed, they cried or whatever. And, you know, clearly Stefan Molyneux won that debate. But they don't see the fact that the entire time he's been jabbing for emotional response. And there's only two ways you can go about responding to that. One is you can, during the debate, explain what they're doing and how you don't appreciate it. And most people are just not going to listen to you anyway. Or you can attempt to do it back. But that's sleazy and it never works out right anyway. Take, for example, and this is why I love this video. I watch it all the time. Stefan Molyneux, when he debated Peter Joseph from the Zeitgeist movement, Peter Joseph does the same thing. He's very good, but he doesn't do it under the guise of jokes like Stefan Molyneux. He does it under the guise of intellectual sophist word salads. So he won't say, like, you're an idiot. You know, you don't know what you're talking about. He'll just say, like, your frame of reference is truncated. So he's saying these things that sound like, you know, he's actually being intellectually critiquing what you're saying. But what he's actually saying is you're an idiot. And the point is to jab him. And Stefan Molyneux at the same time was doing the exact same thing back through his, you know, shitty humor. And it was like a megalomaniac, passive-aggressive war between these guys. And they were both responding to it by getting upset and yelling and getting angry. And I love that video. And it's a prime example of why I don't debate people like Peter Joseph or Stefan Molyneux. They're megalomaniacs. They're really passive aggressive in the way they argue. And particularly Stefan Molyneux, he's very fallacious. And you don't really pick up on the fallacious arguments that he's making until after the fact, that you're like, wait a minute, what he said was just a total, like, straw man, what he just said was total equivocation. I can do a video about that later, but I just wanted to talk about the main reason why I wouldn't debate him is because of his passive aggressive behavior. And I'm not interested in philosophical parlor tricks or argumentative parlor tricks to provoke an emotional response. Not interested in that. And besides, what's the best thing? You know, what's the best case scenario? You know, I get on the show and maybe convince one of his listeners. And the entire time they're just going to get upset and say that it's, you know, a YouTube policy, the DMCA and everything. You know, just typical Steph Bot reactions. But, yeah, I just wanted to mention that. And maybe I'll make a video about Stephon Molyneux and his fallacious reasoning in a later video. So stay tuned for that.